Yeah, I have done other music after the Yardbirds, but anyway, somebody told me I should be proud tonight, but I'm not, because they kicked me out. They did. Fuck them. I have done other music after the Yardbirds, but anyway, somebody told me I should be proud tonight, but I'm not, because they kicked me out. They did. Fuck them.
The story that first Jeff Beck wrote was, where do you go after the Yardbirds? I couldn't just sit around doing nothing. And the first problem was having a lead singer. Oh, God, I hate lead singers. Over here. Help me love you, baby. You're driving my poor heart crazy. Rod Stewart, he looked ridiculous. He had a bullhorn hairstyle, teased up in. Not, it wasn't spiky, it was just all flat, like a kind of a hat. And I thought, well, he's so good, who cares what he looks like, you know? You know, I ain't no oil painting anyways.
Okay, Jeff. Here we go.
This is completely solid.
Yeah, absolutely. These pickups are very powerful.
The strings seem very light. Is this to facilitate the bending?
Partly the notes? Reason is I've got very weak flesh on my fingers.
Yeah.
And the bending that I do, it would probably slice it up like a piece of cheese.
Don't touch it.
I wasn't going to touch it.
No, don't touch it.
I was just pointing at it.
Well, don't point even.
Don't even point?
No, it can't be played. Never. I mean,
Can I look at it?
No.
Take no notice, I don't practice every day now. But I should practice more often, because I've not even got a quarter of the way where I want to go.
to induct Jeff Beck into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, ladies and gentlemen, Jimmy Page.
Thank you. Yeah, thanks, Cleveland, for such a wonderful welcome. I've got to say, you've just seen that wonderful footage up there of a very dear friend of mine, Jeff. And you know, Jeff and I, we go back to really early teens. And let me tell you, that was a long while ago. but we must have been about 13, 14 when we first met. And you know, we stayed friends all the way through. And I did session work, and Jeff was in bands, and then Jeff was in the Yardbirds, and then I was in the Yardbirds with Jeff. And, well, you know, we went on after Jeff started making solo records, and I carried on with the Yardbirds for a while. And we both started to continue in our own sort of way. I sort of had Led Zeppelin, and Jeff kept going, and I got to tell you that you'd sort of listen to Jeff along the way, and you'd go, "Wow, he's getting really, really good, Jeff," you know. and you'd hear him a few years later, and he'd just keep getting better and better and better, and he still has all the way through. And he, you know, he leaves us mere mortals, believe me, you know, just wondering and having so much respect for him, because Jeff's whole guitar style has. It's just totally unorthodox to the way that anyone was taught. And he's just really developed a whole style that of expanding the electric guitar and making it into something which was just sounds and techniques totally unheard of before. And that's just an amazing feat, believe me. As you know, he's done some amazing fusion records. Blow by Blow, for a start, was just a solo record that you know, just established him as just the most incredible soloist of our time, you know. And he just doesn't stop. He gets better and better and better. And I tell you, I'm really honored to be here to induct Jeff into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, because he's done so much for rock and roll, and he always will. Come on, Jeff.
Jim, thank you so much for that. I've been naughty all my life, and I don't deserve this at all. But I shall continue to be naughty, I think. what's that? Sorry, I've lost a bit of hearing. It's all Pete Townsend's fault. but I really don't deserve this. I've been so naughty all my life. But people have been behind me, you know. I've got to mention Ernest Chapman, who looked after my finances, and boy, did he look after them for 30 years. And he steered me through minefields of financial trouble. And he knew nothing about rock and roll, but he had a kind of Colonel Tom Parker quality about him. He sort of knew that if he hung around me long enough, I might do something worthwhile. And he's no longer my manager, because I think he prefers golf. So. We'll let him do that. And I'm very proud that Harvey Goldsmith is now my manager. And here he is right here, Harvey. And big hand for Harvey Goldsmith. Last of all, I mean, there's so many people that have helped me, and I'd like to extend a huge thanks to them, and a huge thanks to those that didn't, you know, help me out. So, thank you, Jim. And to stand here in front of Scotty is just more than I ever could believe, you know, and DJ and all that. Look, you guys, I mean, Jimmy, you'll back me up on this. You know, we used to sit and just, you know, dribble over your playing, you know, fantastic. Thank you for that. Thank you all. Thank you. That's it. And my wife, my dear wife, Sandra.